Hello and welcome to Let's Play Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. My name is Junior, and I'm just going to go ahead and get started. Let's watch the intro video, and be on our way.
I hesitate. Strike me down.
In time, Ron. First, I need something from you.
Morgan Katarn!
This dead man holds the valley's location. Very intriguing. I have no further use for you, old man.
Okay. Well, yeah. So, back in 1997, when this game was made, Direct3D had pretty much just come out. That's incorrect. Direct3D 5 had pretty much just come out. Direct3D had been around for about 5 years. And this is one of the first games to ever use it. They were still using full motion video, of course, because rendering large 3D scenes was still awkward. Let me go ahead and get started here. I'm gonna do the single player campaign. If this goes really well, might do Mysteries of the Sith as well, but for now.
you to remember, son, when you're at the academy, how very proud I am of you. What a fine young man you've become. I wish your mother were here to see it. But I know she watches over you and is proud. After she died, your welfare and upbringing were the only thing I truly cared about.
Touching. When someone desires information, they come to me.
Don't waste my time, 88. Tell me who killed my father.
Patience. He is a dark Jedi.
Jedi?
Dark Jedi. He is known as Jerrick, and he has great plans for the rebirth of the Empire.
I'm not interested in petty political struggles.
Well, you should be. Without going into too much detail, Jerrick has been quite generous in his offerings. Unfortunately, you don't factor into them. But I am not without a heart. Familiar, yes? I found it in your dead father's home. I can decipher any language or code known, but this one eludes me. It must be important. Tell me what it is, and these gentlemen won't have to indulge their darker side.
The dark side? I've been there. Do your worst.
Well, I suppose that concludes our business.
I'm not interested in leaving. I have some business to conclude with your friend, 88.
All right, now into the game proper. You'll see that the resolution is rather low. I am recording at 640 by 480 resolution, mostly because the HUD doesn't scale. So, when I increase the resolution to a very high one, the HUD is really, really tiny, way too hard to read. If I increase the resolution but still show the game at 640 by... like, show the game window at 640 by 40, it's just really, really tiny. Oh! So, pretty much, 88 has something from our dead dad. We have to go get it back.
You always cause trouble.
If you can kill NPCs, if you kill NPCs, you get dark side points. I don't know if I'll be doing dark side or light. I'll have to come to that conclusion later. For now, you'll notice a few things. One is that the HUD is probably flashing every once in a while. This is unfortunately because of the method of recording that I'm using. I can't use Fraps, which is my normal go-to program. So I'm actually using Livestream and using their Procaster tool to record the game. But it causes some interesting little problems. Another thing you'll notice is that this game, like a lot of the older mid-90s games, it's incredibly fast. Movement is really fast. Platforming's really slippery. And the control scheme, by default, is just awful. It's really bad. The user interface is really bad with menus, which is why I didn't go through them during the Let's Play, because they're just awful. I set it all up beforehand. There were things like right mouse button is jump, and crouch is C, control is fire, weapon. Everything's inverted by default, and the sensitivity is incredibly high. Now, you'll also notice that I know this level quite well, although I'm not very good at playing. I do know the level, first level, very well, where all the secrets are, where all the enemies are. But, this is mostly just for the first few levels. As soon as I get a little further in the game, I don't remember where anything is. I played this game many years ago. Actually, I played it when it came out in 1997. So, I haven't actually played it again since beating it the first time, so this should be fun. I'm gonna try not to. Whoa! I'm gonna try not to kill any civilians. Although. I might end up. Main reason for not wanting to kill civilians is I believe you get. An invisibility power? Am I remembering this correctly? I'll find out when I'm. When I'm done with this level. The game has tons of secret areas. Some of them are kind of odd to find, like this one down here. Whoa! Alright, so, death. Death is definitely a thing that can happen in this game. Sorry about that. I'll just have to go and run through this real quick. Once more. Ah. And I'll make sure to save next time I do something stupid like that. The reason I want to get up there is because there's infrared goggles, which are useful. You also notice that I don't. You know what? I'm taking this way too fast. I'm down there.
Get out of my car. You always cause trouble.
Shut up. I'll try to get through here a little faster. And a little. More aware. There are definitely certain items that you need to get. Back to tanks are always good for a tight spot. There are portable health kits. Most health drops and weapon drops you find, shield drops, are pick up and use when you pick it up. But back to tanks, infrared goggles, batteries, those kinds of things. You use later. Well, batteries, not so much. Batteries are kind of, if you look down at the bottom, right-hand corner of the screen, you'll see my ammo count, as well as some dots. The dots on top are the batteries that I have available to me. These power things like my light, which is here, and the infrared goggles, which are very useful in dark places. Because this game is not afraid to put you in pitch blackness. Which a lot of games these days don't do, unless they're specifically survival horror games. Or, games like Doom, which is a horror game. Not too often will you have games that will often put you in pitch black situations. You actually have to rely on your items to see anything. That secret back there. That's right. So, let me just double check my controls to make sure that I have the save command correct. You'll also get to see wonderful menu system. Alright. Let's see. Oh yeah, force powers. You do get force powers later on. You also get a lightsaber, which is kind of, you know, obvious. This is Jedi Knight. Although, Dark Forces, I don't believe it had a lightsaber combat or any force powers in it. Heck is it? Quick save. F9. That's as good as anything, I guess.